डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ आरडी शर्मा क्लास 10 एक्सरसाइज 16.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 62। टू डाइस आर थ्रोन साइमल्टेनियसली, व्हाट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट फाइव विल नॉट कम अप ऑन आइदर ऑफ देम, सेकेंड फाइव विल कम अप ऑन एटलीस्ट वन, एंड थर्ड वन फाइव विल कम अप एट both dice. So in this question there are two dice, they are thrown simultaneously. So possible number of outcomes on first die, six possible outcome, and second die again six possible outcome. So 6 multiplied by 6 is equal to 36. We can write the possible outcomes 1, 1, 1, 2 like this. Here we have to find out the probability of not getting 5 will not come up on either time, means in both time 5 will not come. This probability we have to calculate in first part, and second and third we can calculate the probability. So first write the total number of possible outcomes when two dice are thrown simultaneously. Total number of outcomes is equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6, 3, 2, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 6, and one more, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 5, and 6, 6. This many outcomes are possible when we throw two dice simultaneously. That is 36 possible outcomes. Now, part first. 5 will not come up on either of them. 5 should not become either of them, means not on first die, not on second die. So for this, just write the favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes for 5 will not come up on either of them, is equal to, check how many times 5 are coming first, then subtract this coming 5 on how many times from 36. So we will get the favorable outcomes for 5 will not come up on either of them. So here 5 is coming one time, 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 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, and this is 6, 5. In this many possible outcomes, 5 is coming one time or both time. But we require 5 will not come up either time. So total possible outcome 36 minus this many. Count them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This 11 times 5 is coming. So subtract this 11 from 36. So 36 minus 11 is equal to 25. So in 25 cases, 5 is not coming either of them. Not first time, not second time. Now we have the favorable outcomes and total number of outcomes. So we can write directly the probability. Therefore, probability of getting 5 will not come up on either of them, is equal to total number of possible outcomes 36, favorable number of outcomes 25. So this 25 upon 36 is the required probability of getting 5 will not come up on either of them. Part second, 5 will come up on at least one. 5 will come up on at least one means one time or both time. 5 will be there. So favorable outcomes, for 5 will come up on at least 1 is equal to, in how many times 5 is coming at least 1. So here 1, 5, 5 is coming one time. 2, 5, 5 is coming one time. 3, 5, 5 is coming one time. 4, 5, 5 is coming one time. 5, 1, at least one time 5 coming. 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, and 6, 5. In this many possible outcomes, 5 is coming at least one time. So this 11 are the possible outcomes is equal to 11. Favorable outcomes for 5 will come up on at least one time. These are 11. So therefore, probability of getting 5 will come up on at least 1 is equal to total number of possible outcomes are 36 and favorable outcomes are 11. So 11 upon 36 is the required probability of getting 5 will come up. Part third, 5 will come up at both dice. 5 will come up at both dice. On both dice, 5 will be there. So favorable outcomes for 5 will come up at both dice, So look at, in how many cases 5 is coming on both the dice. So this is only one case when 5 is coming on both dice, 5, 5. So one favorable outcome only. Therefore, probability of getting 5 will come up at both dice एट बोथ डाइस इज इक्वल टू टोटल नंबर ऑफ पॉसिबल आउटकम्स 36, फेवरेबल आउटकम्स 1. सो दिस 1/36 इज द रिक्वायर्ड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग 5 विल ऑन बोथ द डाइस. क्वेश्चन नंबर 63. A number is selected at random from first 50 natural numbers. Find the probability that is a multiple of 3 and 4. A number is selected at random from first 50 natural numbers. Means total possible outcomes are 50 here. So find the probability that it is a multiple of 3 and 4. The number should be multiple of 3 and 4 both. So first write the total number of possible outcomes. Total number of possible outcomes is equal to 50. First 50 natural numbers, so 50. favorable outcomes for a multiple of 3 and 4. So how many multiples of 3 and 4 in this 50 natural numbers? So multiple means the number which is divisible by 3 and 4 are called the multiple of 3 and 4. So in first 50 natural number, 12 is the first number which is divisible by 3 and 4 both. Before 12, there is no number which is divisible by 3 and 4 both. So first multiple of 3 and 4 is 12. Then next number, 12 to 24. This 24 will be the multiple of 3 and 4 because it is divisible by 3 and 4 both. 12 to 24, 12 3 to 36. 36 also the multiple of 3 and 4 both. Then 12 4 to 48. 48 is also multiple of 3 and 4 because it is divisible by 3 and 4. So these out of this 50 natural numbers, only this 4 natural numbers, 12, 24, 36, 48 are divisible by both 3 and 4. So they are the multiples of 3 and 4. That is 4 favorable outcomes. Now we have favorable outcomes and total outcomes. So directly we can write the probability. Therefore, probability of getting a multiple of 3 and 4 is equal to total number of possible outcomes 50, favorable number of possible outcomes 4. We can cancel them. 2 2s are 4 2 2s are 4 2 5s are 10. So this 2/25 is the required probability of getting a multiple of 3 and 4. Question number 64. A dice is rolled twice. Find the probability of 5 will not come up either time and second 5 will come up exactly one time. So a die is rolled twice, means one die is rolled two times. So first time there will be 6 possible outcome and second time again 6 possible outcomes. So total number of possible outcomes will be 36. So first write the total number of possible outcomes like 1, 1, 1, 2. Then we can find out the probabilities of 5 will not come up either time and 5 will come up exactly one time. A die is rolled twice. A die is rolled twice. Then total number of two times, total number of possible outcomes is equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 5, 1, 5,2, 5,3, 5,4, 5, 5, 5, 6, and one more, this 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, and 6, 6. This many possible outcomes are there, that is 36. So we have 36 possible outcome. Now this first part, 5 will not come up either time, means not first time, not second time. So write the possible outcomes first. Favorable outcomes for 5 will not come up either time. Five will not come up either time means not first time, not second time. So search how many times 5 is coming, one time or two time. 1, 5, 5 is coming one time. 2, 5, 5 is coming one time. 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4, 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, 5. In this many possible outcomes, 5 is coming either time, means one time or both time. But we require the favorable outcomes for 5 will not come up either time, means we have to subtract this many possible outcome from total number of possible outcomes. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So subtract this 11 from 36. 36 minus 11 is equal to 25 are the possible outcomes when 5 is not come up either time, not first time, not second time. Now probability of getting 5 will not come up either time. Is equal to total number of possible outcomes 36, favorable outcomes 25. So this is the required probability of getting 5 will not come up either time. Part second, 5 will come up exactly one time. 5 is coming up exactly one time, only one time. So favorable outcomes for 5 will come up exactly one time. So in how many cases 5 is coming exactly one time? Search in how many cases 5 is coming exactly one time. So here 5 is coming exactly one time. 1 comma 5, 2 comma 5, 3 comma 5, 4 comma 5, 5 comma 1, 5 comma 2, 5 comma 3, 5 comma 4, and this 5 comma 5, 5 is coming 2 times. So leave it. 5 comma 6, 5 is coming exactly one time, and 6 comma 5. So in this many cases, 5 is coming exactly one time. So count them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In 10 cases, 5 is coming exactly one time. So favorable outcomes, 10. Therefore, probability of getting 5 will come up exactly one time is equal to total number of possible outcomes 36, favorable outcomes 10. We can cancel them. 2 5s are 10, 2 1s are 2, and 2 8s are 16, 18 times. So which is equal to 5 upon 18. This is the required probability of getting 5 exactly one time. Question number 65. All the black face cards are removed from a pack of 52 cards. The remaining cards are well shuffled and then a card is drawn at random. Find the probability of getting face card, red card, black card and king. So all the black face cards are removed from a pack of 52 cards. After removing all black face cards from 52 cards, so total number of cards will be total number of cards are 52. In that 52 cards, 12 cards are face cards, 4 kings, 4 queens and 4 jacks. So this 12 face cards, 6 face cards are red and 6 face cards are black. So here all 6 black cards are removed from this 52 cards. So 52 minus 6. So 52 minus 6 is equal to 46. So 46 cards are total number of cards after removing all 6 black cards are removed. So 46 cards we have total number of cards after removing black cards, black face cards. Now, one card is drawn from this 46 cards. randomly. So what is the probability of getting a face card? First is face card. Face card. From this many 46 cards, we have to draw one face card. So write favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes for face card. How many face cards in this 46 cards? In 46 cards, only 6 face cards. They are of red color. Black face cards are already removed. So 6 face cards are available in this 46 cards. So favorable cases 6. Therefore, probability of getting face card is equal to total number of possible outcomes 46. Favorable outcomes 6. Cancel them by 2. 2 3 ja 6. 2 2 ja 4. 2 3 ja 6. So this is 3 upon 23. 3 upon 23 is the required probability of getting a face card. Second part, red card. So write favorable outcomes for red card. Favorable outcomes. Outcomes for red card is equal to, so total number of cards are 46, and that 46 cards, 6 black cards are already removed. So out of 52 cards, 26 cards are red and 26 cards are black. Black cards are removed. Total number of cards are 52, and that 52 cards, 26 cards are red and 26 cards are black. But 6 black face cards are already removed. So red cards are 26 will be there. So favorable outcomes for red cards 26. 26. Therefore, probability of getting red card is equal to total number of cards 46. Favorable outcomes for red card 26. Cancel them by 2. 2 1 ja 2, 2 3 ja 6, 2 2 ja 4, 2 3 ja 6. So 13 upon 23. 13 upon 23 is the required probability of getting a red card. Part 3, black card. So favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes for black card is equal to, so out of 52 cards, already 6 black cards are removed. So total number of face cards are 26 in 52. So this 6 black cards are already removed. So 26 minus 6, 20 cards will be black card in that 46 cards. So favorable outcomes for black card 20 only. Therefore, probability of getting black card is equal to total number of possible outcomes 46, favorable outcomes 20. Cancel by 2. 2 1 ja 2, 0. 2 2 ja 4, 2 3 ja 6. So which is equal to 10 upon 23. 10 upon 23 is the required probability of getting a black card. Part fourth, king. So favorable outcomes for king. Favorable outcomes for king. So in 52 cards there are 4 kings, but 6 black cards are removed already. So in that 6 black cards, 2 black kings will be there. So now in the pack of this 46 cards, only 2 kings are remaining, which are of red color. Black color kings are removed. So 4 minus 2 is equal to 2 only. In 46 card there will be 2 kings. Therefore probability of getting king is equal to favorable total number of outcomes 46, favorable outcomes 2. 2 1 ja 2, 2 2 ja 4, 2 3 ja 6, which is equal to 1 upon 23. 1 upon 23 is the required probability of getting a king. Question number 66. Cards numbered from 11 to 60 are kept in a box. If a card is drawn at random from the box, find the probability that the number on the drawn card is. So there is a box. In that box, some cards are there numbered from 1 to 60. They are kept. If one card is drawn at random from the box, so we have to find out the probability that the card drawn is an odd number card, a perfect square number card, divisible by 5 number card, a prime number less than 20 cards. So first write the total number of cards. So total number of cards is equal to numbered from 11 to 60, 11, 12, 13, dot dot 60. So this many cards, so how many this cards here? 11 to 60, first 10 cards number 1 to 10 are missing, so total number of cards will be 50. That is 50 cards which are numbered from 11 to 60. Now first part, an odd number. So write the favorable outcomes for odd number card. Favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes for an odd number. So how many odd numbers? How many odd number cards here? Start from card number 11. So card number 11 is odd. Then 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, 29, 31, 33, 35, 37, 39, 41, 43, 45, 47, 49, 51, 53, 55, 57, and 59. This many cards are of odd number card which are not divisible by 2. Count them, how many? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 21 22 23 24 25 that is 25 cards are odd number cards. So therefore probability of getting an odd number card and odd number is equal to total number of cards 50, favorable number of cards 25. 25 1 jar 25, 25 2 jar 50. So this is 1 upon 2 is the required probability of getting an odd number card. Part second, a perfect square number card. So favorable outcomes, so favorable outcomes for a perfect square number, a perfect square number. So how many cards are perfect square number? Start from 11. 11 is not a perfect square of any number. 12 is not perfect square. 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 is the first card which is perfect square of 4. 16, then 25 is the perfect square of 5. Then 36, perfect square of 6. 49 is the perfect square of 7. And 8 8 jar 64. 64 is perfect square of 8, but card number 64 is not available here. So only this many cards numbers which are perfect square. So count them, how many? 1 2 3 4. So this four cards are perfect square number cards. Therefore probability of getting a perfect square number is equal to total number of cards 50, favorable number of cards 4, 2 2s are 4 2 2s are 4 2 5s are 10 2 upon 25 2 upon 25 is the required probability of getting a perfect square number card. Part third, divisible by 5. So write the favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes for divisible by 5. So how many cards here which are divisible by 5? So from 11 is not divisible by 5. 12 13 14 15, 15 is divisible by 5. Then 20 divisible by 5. 25 divisible by 5. 30 divisible by 5. 35 divisible by 5, 40 divisible by 5, 45 divisible by 5, card number 50 divisible by 5, 55 divisible by 5, and card number 60 divisible by 5. So this many cards which are divisible by 5, count them, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So these 10 cards are divisible by 5, therefore probability of getting divisible by 5 is equal to total number of cards 50, favorable number of cards 10, 2 5s are 10, 10 directly we can cancel this, टेन वन जा टेन एंड टेन फाइव जा फिफ्टी विच इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन फाइव इज द रिक्वायर्ड प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ गेटिंग अ कार्ड डिविजिबल बाय फाइव. लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 66 पार्ट 4. लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 66 पार्ट 4. A number, a prime number less than 20. Prime number less than 20, so write favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes for a prime number less than 20. Less than 20 is equal to. So, you know, prime number, the number which is divisible by only one and itself are called prime numbers. So, how many prime numbers cards which are less than 20? So, start from card number 11. 11 is a prime number card which is less than 20. 11. Then 13 is also prime number which is less than 20. 13. Then 17 is also prime number which is less than 20. And one more, 19 is a prime number which is less than 20. So only this many cards. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4 cards. Prime number cards which are less than 20. So therefore, probability of getting a prime number less than 20 is equal to total number of cards 50, favorable number of cards 4, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. So this is 2 upon 25. This is the required probability of getting a prime number less than 20. So I think it's enough for today. The remaining questions of this exercise we will solve in next class. Okay, bye.